Katana, can you just move a little bit that way?
So Black Friday and Cyber Monday just passed. A little statistics on that. So this year, Americans exceeded $7 billion in total sales. And it was expected by companies to surpass, they wanted consumers to spend about 10% more than they did in 2016. But we surpassed that by a margin of 16%. And so today I want to talk about materialism in our everyday society, and mainly its negative impact, how it leads to like a lost sense of self and kind of keeps us buried in the sense of normativity. So two of the main players we can talk about when talking about the psychology of buying is Richardson Dawson's and their 18-item value material scale that they created in 1992, centered around these three acquisitions of happiness, centrality, and success. They evade questions such as like really broad questions like on a scale of 1 to 5, how happy do you feel after you make a purchase? Or like really blamed questions such as like how materialism like affects like your overall life, like, oh, the items in my everyday life aren't that important to me. And their main findings were centered around happiness. We found that like, on an average score of 49.7, happiness was the lowest category almost every single time in every participant, with an average score of 13.7. Don't laugh. But one of the examples that I think we can look to in our everyday society is like this hype-based culture, which I kind of define as like anybody who wears like brands like Supreme, Bape, Palace, and it kind of becomes like an obsession, like they just want like the latest and greatest things. And something that's really interesting historically is we've kind of seen like in the past like decade a change, like only celebrities used to wear like big like hype-based brands. Like it used to be like Gucci and Ralph Lauren and Cardi bracelets. And it's not just for people like Kanye West anymore, it's everybody. And I want to briefly touch on the idea of what's the difference between an impulse buy and splurge buying. So an impulse buy is like, say you're at the grocery store and you see like a candy bar and you're at the checkout and somehow it just like magically ends up in your cart. And a splurge buy is, we've all been in both of these situations. A splurge buy is when like you really want like this nice like leather jacket, or you're saving up to buy a new car. It's more like methodically planned out. And compulsive buying more leads to like behavioral problems later on in life. Like it's kind of like a reckless spending mentality. And I think in our society, like consumers are more like set up to fail automatically when we have all these temptations in front of us. And it's further fueling this loop of dissatisfaction. It only really leads to temporary happiness in the end. The way that we can solve this problem is you really gotta think before you shop. Minimalism is a really prevalent topic right now. Like I've seen like a lot of like bloggers and moms and people writing books on minimalism, so it might be something cool to look into. Your identity is a lot bigger than what you buy is the main thing that I'm trying to get at. So yeah.